FMG's siege really strong. If they ever approach a tower, they're very scary. But at the same time saying that, that means that they're open to flanks, and RNG's composition is so good at punishing that.
All right, guys, we're getting into game for a final series of the day. It's going to be game one here between OMG and RNG. So yeah, who can come out on top? Both these teams being struggling, but very excited to see what this one will hold. And already we have Axe in the bottom lane. Of course we do. Four members stacked up there looking for a kill. Five was dropping low. We'll see what we're looking for in terms of summoners. It was Icon's flash burn. He must have flashed and charmed. And that will be exchanged for Ming's flash in the bottom lane too.
Yeah, Uzi also stalling out some of the backs right there. In response though, Bebe did sneak up towards the red buff and drop down some vision. So RNG should at least get information about where OMG are starting. Usually standard is to start the top side anyway, especially now that Ming has no flash.
Definitely makes sense here. And Bebe on this Vi.
How excited are you for Vi?
Pretty excited. Definitely at least a 9 out of 10 on the 10 scale of excited for Vi. We've seen a little bit of it. It has like seeped in again when, you know, the top tier picks are gone. She just sit in that B tier class, but just in solo queue as well, it's just like complete nightmare. It's the point and click ultimate along with Let Me's point and click ultimate. And if you are anyone, pretty much, in terms of a squishy, like Jiang, good luck getting away from that. Again, same with Icon and Caitlyn, you know, there's like very little you can do, and almost a perfect answer to this Ahri in the mid lane. Holding that thought for a second, there's a lot of trading going on in the bottom lane.
A lot of trading. Look at a lot of Thunderlords. We just saw the keystones
League of Thunderlords. What is this, like 2016 again? And it's like the release of Thunderlords. I mean, there's literally 10 Thunderlords in the game.
Come on, guys. That's so last year.
Yeah. Get on the Courage of the Colossus hype train.
So the one that I do want to point out is that both AD carries, not taking Fervor, taking Bloodlust. Again, we saw more of kind of a Fervor spike from the LPL AD carries just because there was a lot of tank supports running around. When you have mage supports running around and they chunk you out for so much, you need to really rely on your lifesteal and Bloodlust so you can even just survive in the lane. That's rude.
Oh, he's going to follow him after. Come on, get back here with my blue buff. Thank you very much. So,
I bet
he'll get it in the end.
Yeah, had to smite it away, but that was actually quite a cheeky little play there. Xiaohu shoving the wave forward and then disappearing in between the creep waves to try to contest that blue buff. Almost had it too. Bebe actually came over the wall and tried to take it away.
That was just kind of very comical.
Would have been awesome if it worked.
Oh yeah, I mean like triple buffing the Lee Sin at this stage in the game, almost shutting him out for the next couple minutes. But regardless, he's got a level 3 now. And a double buff, so maybe he can make something happen in the bottom lane.
But Ming and Uzi should be aware that Lee Sin's hanging around. There's the flash.
Flash, but it lands onto Ming. He's under attack. The flash from his Rage Rate. Can he land the Q? Yes, he can. And Ming will go down for first blood.
Teleport
over to the Caitlyn. Can he close this around them? Bebe's coming in, looking for that Vault Breaker. Flash in with the Riptide. Oh, someone's going to die and make it too. Five is so low, but the Dredgeline landing will be the double kill out there for RNG. But the action's not over. This game is delivering on that front. Icon comes in. Jiang picks up the kill. What is going on, Frost?
Okay, so both top laners have now burned teleport. Let's kind of restock, take what happened. Oh, wow. Let Me got both kills. Okay, so fast forward, here's the replay. Ming, he doesn't have flash. He should have known that this gank was coming. They saw that Lee Sin was on the bottom side of the map. First teleport comes through and it's Let Me. And again, he's going to be the big benefactor here of this play because he picks up both of the kills. Icon's also coming to roam down, which is why Xiong doesn't cancel his teleport here because he feels that the cavalry has arrived. In the end, Gangplank also picks up a kill, taking, ooh, Xiong, Bonnie Cinder. That's still really rough, especially for how early it is in the game. That Sheen proc damage is actually going to be disgusting if he can land it.
It's a lot. It really is a lot. We need the fan vote coming out here. 66% over to RNG. I honestly just can't call it at this point in the game. So much action already.
I feel like we've had like really kind of methodical, drawn out, slow games, and it's like RNG versus OMG. Buckle up.
Yeah, we're going in. We're going in hard. All right. So we didn't see a kill onto Icon, unfortunately. Kappa Bride.
That's what she said.
Back into the mid lane. Double Darren.
I'm sorry, we just that once.
Oh, man, it's just been such a fast game.
Okay, check out SMLZ's itemization at 5 minutes into this game. 34 CS. Uzi decided to go, unfortunately, into Longsword and Cole just due to back timings. SMLZ held off and now has a full BF sword. So this is a huge swing of power, despite the fact that it looked bad for OMG's bottom lane after it all panned out and Let Me came down with the TP. Massive power spike in his favor.
And I'll be great against, you know, a person like Uzi, and we're talking about Uzi being the X Factor. He's the guy to look at for RNG, and now he's laying against the Caitlyn with a BF sword, so already shutting that down a little bit in terms of threat. Would it be nice if Icon had picked up a kill, maybe if Jiang didn't greedily take that one away to top lane?
I mean, the good thing for him is he does have the tools, because it is Ash Misfortune, that he shouldn't actually really be laning against the Caitlyn. He can just control the creep wave, have it push forward, chip away with that volley. Although if Jueyue continues to camp down here,
he's gonna tell Uzi, and that's exactly what they want
just
for OMG.
Pitch a tent.
Come on, all right. Ming does not want to be on the top side of the lane here.
It's important that Five doesn't have his flash, so they don't have the ability to flash root again. That's what gave them the kill in the first place. But look at how patient Shui Shui is being.
And they're pushing up. Ming taking a lot of damage. He is recalling. But if I'm Lee Sin, yeah, I'm gonna stop the recall and reconsider, because it just looks too good. And with this trap line as well, you know they're going to be cornered against the wall. Here comes Zreze once again, lands the Q onto Uzi. Fast kill. And you look at the player cam, Uzi just kind of shaking his head. It's like, yeah, I'm tilted.
And that's when your tendencies betray you. You know that Uzi wants to contest the creeps. You know that he's going to step forward and look for the volley. And they were just patient enough to communicate for the window. But hold on, actually a roam coming out of Xiaohu. They do have Xiang underneath the tower. If they killed him underneath it, it'd be super punishing because he doesn't have his TP. But it looks like Xiang's actually going to read that and he's like, Syndra's missing? I'm out of here.
Really good from OMG at the start of this game. That was really heads up, you know, seeing not in the mid lane. He's playing the bottom lane as well. Icon playing to the bottom side of his lane as well. So literally just not getting anything from this. And to be fair, two kills did go over to Let Me, so he's going to be pretty big. And also got to get up to the top lane faster. So big minion wave discrepancy in terms of CS top lane and mid lane, but the kills going over to OMG. So in total, there is still a slight gold advantage to RNG. It's negligible, but in terms of where the gold is situated, that's where you have to look at.
And I will give props to Xiaohu, even though he wasn't able to commit anything to the top lane, him simply disappearing into Fog of War actually helped open up that CS discrepancy between the top laners, because a wave was crashing on Xiang's turret, so he lost a lot there.
And again, just farming out this bottom lane. Uzi most likely going to be playing slightly more defensive. He already thought he was, but even more so.
He's in a lot of bad ways. That's double longsword Cole into BF boots and dagger. And SMLZ can now kind of manipulate and control the wave to continue to punish him. Now, fortunately for Uzi, he does have his flash backup and available, but unfortunately for Uzi, so does Five.
And double unfortunately, he's Ray in the bottom side of the map once more. They do have some ward set up, but he may look for like a lane gank this time. There's a control ward, so got to be fearing another potential gank from Dre. He's moved on to his Gromp, so impending doom.
Yeah, and he was actually spotted out with that hot shot from Uzi. You immediately see the pings go down, and suddenly Uzi's like, and I'm way back. I've seen this one before.
Gonna stand at my tower for a bit. Let's go back up to the mid lane, because Icon was a big focus for us. Let's see if Xiaohu can shut him out. He's got that big CS discrepancy just because of all of the fighting that we've seen and Icon's involvement in that.
No.
I'll say no for now. Ming, lots of damage coming in from Five. I'm just keeping my eye on the river real quick, because there's both a jungler and mid laner potentially going head to head.
And again, remember that Xiaohu and Beibe contested the blue buff the first time around, so well aware of the timer. They knew that Jueyue and Icon were going to be on that side of the map, trying to get cheeky, trying to catch Icon, maybe walking back into his lane, and now they continually are cheating bottom, and they have the option to do that because Uzi has the Ash Arrow. Yes, he's down in itemization, but the burst damage and kill threat from the Vi as well as the Syndra, still holding a lot of power there. Xiaohu was actually just like bullying Icon around.
Yeah, I mean, now we're at the point where people are getting to level 6 points. Dreje over the wall catches him in the scatter of the week, and Dreje will flash over the wall. Another dash from the Spirit Rush, and both of the OMG members make it out alive.
And that was the play from RNG. They knew that they had the kill pressure on pretty much anyone that they wanted because the Syndra had her ultimate. Vi also with her ultimate. Huge damage there. They even pulled down Let Me. And luckily for OMG, they weathered the storm. Yes, they burned their flash as well as their ultimate to disengage from it, but it's kind of a sigh of relief where things can calm down from that mid lane power.
And I know it was tactical because you know, Ming probably had to go back to base anyway. It was just funny watching Uzi do a typical Uzi thing. It's just like, what, that ult is locked on you? Yeah, you can take that. I'm going to stick around and farm, mate. So Ming has to prove himself to his new ADC that he's worthy. Flash out of the way from 5. Good reaction times. And Baby coming down there as well. So no Vault Breaker to hit. He's just kind of keeping Uzi company, allowing him to farm under tower.
And SMLZ has a lot of confidence to be this far forward, knowing that that Vi ultimate is down. Yes, they're aware that Ming has gone back, so it is technically a 2v1 scenario, but they're not as fragile in the lane, knowing that Syndra and Vi have lost kind of those big cooldowns. And that's kind of that sigh of relief that we were talking about.
And Uzi in much better shape now. He's really just able to farm, and he's got a fairly decent freeze. Yeah, Kayn's going back to base using that Piltover Peacemaker. So, actually, no, sticking around. I am a liar. I'm lying to you. Icon back in this mid lane has picked up the Hextech Revolver. We'll see if it goes for the Super Soaker. That was a build that was being talked about for a little bit around Worlds.
Yeah, because it helps you survive the burst. In fact, this matchup into Syndra, when Syndra was really just destroying Worlds, I mean, she's always been kind of a priority pick even on 7.1. Faker actually said that this was going to be the counter, or at least the planned counter that he had, because it allows Ahri to get tanky enough and have enough utility that she can survive the Syndra burst.
Hello, it's AJ getting caught out by Bebe. I just realized both junglers have like a repeating word. That's pretty cool.
Shui Shui and Bebe?
Yeah. Maybe I should just like call them first one. Like, because Kid did that as well. Now he's Kid. Is this something with the junglers? Icon getting called out. Lots of damage in from Bebe. Didn't follow up with the ultimate. Not off cooldown just yet. And Icon also dropping very low.
But the damage has been done. The fact that Icon's blinking red, he's trying to pot up so he can safely kind of at least hover behind, way back behind this tower and clear the creep wave. And they're actually not going to contest for mid lane, they're going to threaten the top side of the map.
Here he comes. He's got the ultimate this time around, and well, good luck. These are two pointer click ultimates coming your way. He can't move, there was nothing he could do. Oh, that's got to feel bad.
And Xiang did it properly the first time around. The communication was there where he backed off. This time around, he actually burned his ultimate trying to help Icon disengage, and then foolishly stayed around on the turret. This time around pays for it, and unfortunately it's just a trade of the Cloud Dragon for a ton of damage, in fact the tower falling down, so huge swing for RNG.
This is going to be a very big Nautilus. Not only have he got those 3 kills, but the tower's also down. Yep, Ming, you take that one to the face. And he's just going to be unkillable. Already finished the Sunfire Cape at 13 minutes. And a Kindle Gem. Oh no, he's really siding. Sold it. What's it going to be? Negatron Clip.
Yep. Cool. He's got his Ninja Tabby. Well, he's already got so much armor with the Ninja Tabby as well as the completed Sunfire at 13 minutes into the game.
Yeah, pretty massive. So Uzi will have a great front line for him, so he'll be feeling good.
Gonna have that front line immediately. Letmi is now just going to walk through the bottom of this lane, and SMLZ and 5 immediately have to give respect because he's sitting on the arrow, and as soon as the Nautilus shows up, that arrow is going to fly, and if it hits them, they're going to pick up a kill, and it's going to roll over into a tower. So RNG playing this very smart and immediately unlocking their top laner and continuing the structure snowball.
I feel like that audio bug
is just driving me nuts.
I feel like Letmi must have been seen there, but maybe not. Because he's still camping the bush. Nah, he's gone back to base. Okay, so he was spotted out there, unfortunately, by OMG's minion wave.
Yeah, it's because Xiang, you can't afford to freeze anymore, because if you do, you're just going to put your other map at a disadvantage from numbers. So he smartly shoved the wave in to try to at least force Letmi just to sit in the lane. Of course, this puts him in a really precarious situation because he is so far extended. Luckily for him, though, Bebe's in front of him.
So he knows at least what one of the threats is, and he knows he has, like, again, the recall timing, and then maybe another 30 seconds if Bebe just decides to go into the top lane. So he's got a nice little grace period for himself before he needs to back away.
He messed up by staying on the tower and letting it fall in the first place and giving away the kill, but he made up for it by alleviating some pressure on SMLZ and 5's lane. It's like, get your crap out of here.
Uzi saying to Ming, come on man, where were you? He's there, setting up a kill onto Treyje. Oh, but he uses him as a bowling ball. Come on Ming, what are you doing? And he wasn't his fault. He's gonna go down for the second kill. Bebe with his ultimate slams against the ground. A 2-for-1 in favor of OMG. Meanwhile, Caitlyn getting caught out by Zhao Hu, but the dredge line from Letmi should be the kill. Comes in with the anchor. Run away from this one, Icon. Okay, he did.
So again, another great collapse from RNG there. In fact, 5. Oh no.
Can he make
it?
Oh
no.
Bebe? Anything? No.
5 managed to slip out there. And this is from the difference of the fact that the Nautilus is going to mean so much more when two TP's down versus the Gangplank. Like, this is your consolation prize. The Gangplank ultimate coming down here. And I just want to take a moment. The flash forces the Rage ultimate out, even though the tower probably would have ticked it down. It was so well played initially from Zhe Zhe, and then it's like, all right, Nautilus teleported down. Our Gangplank is pretty worthless if he TP's down. There goes our fun time.
I like to imagine Uzi is extremely angry in this game. Like, he's being camped in the bottom lane. Like, Ming was just used as a bowling ball and killed him. Like, he's gotta not be feeling great.
Meanwhile, Letmi's like, this is a great game. This is awesome,
living
guys.
Life.
That is fun.
I'm huge. 4-0-0 Nautilus. Having a great time.
And the hilarious thing is, it's not like Bebe is like returning top lane. He keeps going bottom. But yeah. Letmi also is just getting all of those leftover kills.
Well, it's now time for Letmi just to convert to an ADC build and be the damage that team needs. Because you look at the opposite side, and OMG's kills are pretty much spread across the board. So it's not like a single member is just massive. It's really going to come down to when we look at these team fights and we see objectives being traded back and forth, but how much will that actually matter?
Also comes down to itemization, so completed items. Uzi looking for the Essence Reaver Ash build, so kind of going a bit of a throwback. It became quite popular in the LPL. To prioritize that Infinity Edge because they like to prioritize the team fighting. So again, more of that utility, it makes sense, it's kind of behind, you want more of the CDR as well as the damage. It's not a terrible build on Ashe, I mean, it was standard for a very long time.
Sure.
Whereas on the other side, you have SMLZ who has completed his Infinity Edge, he didn't go for the 2 flat damage items and then into the attack speed, so he is ready to 5v5 right now.
Really what he wants, but the Triforce, yeah, picked up. Like a big Gangplank.
This Caitlyn build is not the I'm farming side lanes and pushing towers build. This is I'm grouping up. We need to make it happen.
Yeah, we are going. We're going to make something happen. Icon hasn't been back in a while, I feel, because he's been sat on those items for a fair bit. I want to see him finish the... Oh, it's going to be
Proto
Belt.
Belt.
Okay, so when we did see a little bit of Ahri, we were all like, Super Soaker, Super Soaker, but then they all went Proto Belt. So once again, we're seeing that from Icon. But he's kind of past the point where, you know, Zhao Hu is laning against him, so he's not under that threat. It's when we get into team fights where it's like, hello, and he just nukes him with ult.
That different mentality. It's like, well, I'm not going to just tank and survive the ultimate. I'm actually just going to dodge the stun. Mm. So I'm going to get an extra flash key.
So he gets, you know, more room to maneuver, and he's going to be, like, diving Uzi most likely as well. Maybe, you know,
this poor guy, Uzi.
Look at him. Like, he's just getting bullied at the moment, to be honest.
It's just one of those games.
Yeah. And you know, the opposite side, you're like, ah, yeah, star player, Icon, 001, has not even really been touched in this game.
I said X Factor.
Okay, X Factor. Changing my words. We'll wait another 10 minutes, and if he goes off, then I'll call him.
To be fair, the other X Factor in this game is Uzi. He's sitting 0-2-3 right now, so.
Yeah.
Kind of a delayed start on both ends.
That's fair.
Although I feel like.
More delayed in one case, I'd say.
Icon really only has himself to blame. I feel like Uzi's been up against a wall a bit.
Yeah.
20 people in his lane.
I have to agree with that one. Quick clear out of the bottom lane. Sticking the mid laner down there. Giving Caitlyn some time to farm in the mid lane. Alright, I want team fights to happen. That's what I'm looking for.
Well,
ocean dragon's up.
I was going to say, there's an ocean dragon up.
Alright. How much does the LPL love ocean dragons?
It's not really about the ocean dragon. It's actually just about the fact that it creates a coliseum.
Excellent. That's what I wanted to hear. All right, Bebe clearing out the area. Lots of wards coming down from RNG.
But I actually prefer this call from RNG. So they have 2 different options here. You can either force the wave, which means that OMG need to be behind it and clear it out, which they're going to do with the Gangplank ultimate, and then you can kind of cheat back into the dragon. But it's this idea that when they approach towers, they're also terrifying. You got the Ash area, you have the Cinder ultimate, and now they have the superior positioning on the dragon.
Well, that was anti-fun.
That is great.
Yeah, but like GP just ruined all the fun. There's no fight. He's gonna kill the dragon. Now we're gonna back away. There's no objective for them to fight over now. However, I did see a team fight over Riftheld earlier, but he's gone back to the void, so that's sad. All right, something's gotta open up a fight soon.
Well, they want to take the last standing outer in the top side of the map, or they want to try to pick someone in the mid side. But unfortunately for OMG, again, they're lacking a ton of that CC. So I feel like their best case scenario is actually to shadow underneath Xiong and really pressure Letmi off the tower.
Hook doesn't quite land onto Xiong. Probably wouldn't have been a kill regardless. I mean, Bei is on his way to the top side of the map. And seeing that ward, okay. So, on Waypoint duty, once again, Uzi taking that one. That's hurting a little bit more now. It was just ranked up to rank 2 for the Aeson holder. Yahoo lying in wait, seeing if he can just catch anyone who happens to be chilling around this area. And he did catch Icon, so we'll see him go back into the mid lane.
He has vision on Icon as well. He's actually stacking up his orbs.
The Patient Hunter. Oh, arrows land. And the taunt as well. What a god. Icon. Oh no. Okay,
the taunt walks directly into
it just like instantly dies. That would have been fantastic, but yeah. No, he did see the dark sphere over the wall. So he'll take his blue buff and move on with his life. 21 minutes in, 10 kills. A nice. I was going to say healthy Goldie, but there's honestly nothing really in it between these two teams. It's just that one tower going down, so it's just the difference of dragons with that ocean dragon and the cloud dragon. The next one's going to be another ocean dragon.
What I find interesting right now is that both mid laners have pretty much given their AD carries the mid lanes. That was about 30 to 45 seconds where both Icon and Xiahou were sitting off in the wings, just like bogarting river. You finally see, like, this is the first time Xiahou's farmed in probably a minute.
Finally back, getting that under his belt. Solid Mirana on the card and haunting guys right now. And he's in the bot lane. We'll be able to get Xiang from full health. And Xiang is currently sat on 2 items as well. The very nice point for GP players is when you hit those 2 item breakpoints and you just one-shot waves and start chunking through people. So again, he's also in a position where he's like, I want to fight. Got him.
The big thing, though, is Uzi is about to get his ultimate, and last time it didn't connect. This time, we'll see if that changes, because that air is going to make or break that mid-tower.
Yep. Just needs to land onto somebody, and it's just about up.
I have a feeling it's going to be 5.
I think that's likely. 5 does have his flash, though, and we've seen previously that he is pretty good on the old F key there, so... Might be able to get that one just in time. There's no one without a flash, which is the kind of the problem right now. Like, he can burn a flash, but apart from that, nothing else.
Xiang! Oh no! He let it go again. He didn't make the same mistake.
Okay, that's fine, that's fine. Bot lane is under attack, and he should be able to pick up this tower. So he didn't make the mistake of just staying in the tower and dying, but they all lose the tower.
And this is RNG abusing their lane assignments, so kicking Xiahou out to the bottom side. He pretty much has kill pressure on every single person on the map. It's one of the problems with OMG's comp is they don't have a true tank, so they don't have anyone who can absorb that Syndra damage. And just through slow whittling and the proper lane assignments, they're able to pick up the tower in the end.
So objective being traded. And it's got to be soon. We've got to see a fight. I feel it. Okay. Blooper seems like a good objective to fight over. Joyce Ray is gonna come in here. Baby's chasing after. Let me. There's the ultimate. He's gonna go down. No real worries there. SMLZ. I'm not entirely sure what you're doing there, mate. But I think he'll be okay. Let me does have his ultimate, but he wasn't able to get in range in time. So that's just the one kill going over to RNG for now.
I'm going to have to disagree with you a bit, Pulse.
Alright.
I don't agree with fighting over blue buff as a good idea.
But it means action! And that's what I enjoy. That's what I wanted from these two teams. We're going to see a fight over mid lane. Uzi detonated by Icon. That's what we said in Champions. Like, Icon, when he's on the assassin versus Uzi, who's not having a great game, who comes out on top? The Ahri.
Yeah, the Zyra and the Ahri actually kind of... Not Zyra didn't flash on top of him, but Ahri certainly did. But Zyra also dropped in the ultimate, managed to stall out to see mid lane. And in the end, Xiang actually picks up the inner tower on the bottom side of the map.
So who won out from that?
Well, the inner tower is going to be worth a lot more than any sort of positioning in mid lane.
That makes sense. Let me just slowly kill Gangplank, but he is a lot faster than a very slow Nautilus.
He's also got his Hex Drinker, which means it's now much safer for Xiang to be in these side lanes, despite the fact if it is the Nautilus or if it is the Syndra.
Much harder for him to get bursted down. Bring out this mid wave as well. They were trying to find a pick with Scatter Weak, and they put that trap in a very annoying position, which is just above the tower. And 6-6 in kills, so just clearing out the rest of these traps. And what are we doing in terms of items? So Void Staff just picked up as the second item coming in from Icon. Notice he's going to have to try and chunk through both the top laner and jungler, who are very rapidly getting towards their magic resist items. And Uzi Still not having a great game. He sat on two items though, so it's not too bad. He's been farming pretty decently. He's just not been able to really make anything happen from these fights.
Five is a crazy man. I don't know if you saw that, but he like ran forward and ducked underneath the Syndra stun. If he gets hit with that, he's gonna get popped like a balloon.
Honestly, Five has been pretty good when it's been coming to getting out of like CC skill shots. He's been impressed by how he's been dodging out of those. So,
I mean, no surprises there, but that Five would be very good at hitting the root. Again, when he joined this team, he was kind of known as almost a Thresh one trick. Very good on that champion, so death sentence very similar to Zyra's team.
Sure.
But he's been having some nice fancy footwork, and their mid lane push wins them positioning to secure an Ocean Drake.
Oh, again! Five. Oh, yeah, dodge this one, mate. Bebe coming in there with Jao, who's ultimate. Gonna finish him off instantly. Bebe will fall for that one.
Jungle for support, I'd gladly take it.
And Icon coming off to let me. He's gonna use a Spirit Rush. Meanwhile, Jao Hu, nice dodge out of that Q. And now Zwaydre caught up a creek without a paddle, pretty much. There's nothing he can do about this one. And Caitlyn caught out. There comes the Riptide. Let me will finish him off with the anchor. Coming in there with the 3-for-1 to RNG.
Target selection there, really punishing Shui Shui. He does manage to get the nice kick on Xiaohu, but he's got his completed Hourglass, which gives him the team fight as well as the position advantage to take mid-outer.
Really big for RNG there. I actually think the key point of that fight was the Zhonya's coming in, so Shui Shui couldn't get back out again.
Oh yeah, so we are going to see a replay of this. It's like you said, Five with the fast feet managed to dodge the Ash Arrow, and it's kind of
look
almost the insta-response Bebe with the point click.
Instantly detonated, but then like the instant traps coming down from Caitlyn as well just kind of trapped him in there.
As well as the Zyra ultimate and the GP ultimate layered on top of each other. But then it's right here. Shui Shui finds Xiaohu, actually burns his flash for it, but a really nice Zhonya, and then Ming positions well to just annihilate the team with bullet time. And from there, let me. He's massive, he's very tanky. AssimLZ cannot deal with the Nautilus, just doesn't have the shred, despite the fact that she does have her last whisper and just gets walked down.
I mean, that's like a 2.5 item ADC with, yeah, with Last Whisper, but Letmi is like, what, 5-0 right now? He's so big.
But Uzi is waiting on his Cole. I know it's not going to completely eclipse the difference of the Last Whisper, but he's actually not that far behind despite all of the troubles that have been thrown at him in that bottom lane as soon as he procs that gold value on it. In fact, wow, he's actually going for a defensive item, so not looking for the armor penetration. This makes sense. I mean, he's got enough damage in the likes of the Vi, as well as the Syndra, as well as the Misfortune, that he's really just a utility bot. And that's kind of cool of Uzi to show his change, his growth, and his maturing as a player, that he doesn't need to be that hard carry, that he can be a team player.
The funny thing is, he still dealt the most damage in that last team fight, so like he's still doing fine. He's still in good shape.
I think that's more so on Xiaohu.
Yeah, probably, but into this top side, lots of vision has come down from both teams. The crab, okay, it went over to RNG. Uzi picks that one up, and Baron is still a possibility. I didn't realize it was 28 minutes in, but it's now something that both teams could contest. We had a big lull period where both teams didn't really look for those fights, so more just taking objectives, looking for picks, trying to be smart.
Watching Letmi over on the side, he's actually looking for a big flank. Instead, he's just going to drop some deep vision, perhaps disappear back to bottom lane. And like you said, it's now turned into the Baron dance.
And it's turned into Bebe jumping on Zwaydre. Oh, jump away. Five gets out, but the Lee Sin's not so lucky. The follow-up. Xiaohu instantly detonated, and there's Ming over the wall. Bullet time lands onto one-for-one trade so far, and Uzi just like in the middle of nowhere. GP versus Nautilus. He may get away with that blast plant usage. He's gonna follow after. It's gonna take a long time to get. There's another blast plant. Go on, you can make it. I have faith in you, Nautilus. That was weird.
Visual.
He's out. Yes. Good job. Okay.
But suddenly that's two members only alive for RNG. Letmi does have his teleport, but he still needs to respawn for base. And OMG are going to go ahead and pull the trigger on the Baron, despite the fact that their jungler is dead. Here comes the TP from Letmi. There is no smite for OMG, so there's still a chance.
Let's go, Nautilus. It's going to be secured by Icon. That was a bit dodgy, considering Make It Rain was there as well. But either way, it will be secured by OMG. and that is a big win for them.
Yeah, so in the end, huge props to Xiang. The fact that he was able to chase Letmi for so long to delay that back timing, because you saw there, that 5 second window was really the difference between Nautilus getting to the Baron pit too late and Nautilus getting into the pit before Baron went down. That damage from Icon yeah. is absolutely disgusting coming over the wall. And Shui Shui almost survives this fight. But this is RNG just really uncoordinated in their team fight. People getting caught out, not coming from the same side, and not layering their cooldowns correctly.
Mm-hmm. For sure. And Letmi really needs to be involved in these fights, you know? Like, he's a lot of that gold on that team is on that Nautilus.
Oh, you mean you can't go 5-0-1 and just split push as a Nautilus and win the game?
It's true. Oh, that ultimate went on Ming. That's a new one. you can see, feeling a bit of respite. And right now, OMG, balls in their court. They can do pretty much anything they want. Mid lane could be going down, but
there's the
big flank from Letmi taken out for ADC to start this one off. Nice double stun coming in from Zhao, who Letmi is just absolutely unkillable. This is what we were talking about. Once he gets involved, what can they do? Icon looking for the detonate onto Zhao, who Zonius comes out. He's good to go. 3-0 so far. Letmi looking for another target for his anchor to land. And Dre, he's out jumping to that ward, and they're good to go.
And suddenly what looked good for OMG has now fallen apart at the seams. We talked about how their composition really wants to be forward and to siege underneath the tower, but the problem is that leaves them open for flanks. And the big flanking play for RNG is Letmi, and he is massive.
Nautilus, ladies and gentlemen, this is what he'll do to you when he's 6-0-3. Moving on to the inhibitor now. That's gone. It's out. It's done.
Yeah, those feels when you secure Baron and it's your mid inhib that goes down.
Yeah, yeah, that's a negative Baron play for sure. Now the Cloud Dragon is up, so RNG will have priority over that. Probably going to go back to base first, since there are a decent amount of low health bars. And wait for OMG to head over to that area, so maybe they'll pick this one up. That's actually fairly decent for OMG if they do manage to pick up Dragon, because then they could start playing around Elder in a long while from now.
And that is easier for them than playing in lanes, because they have to be less vigilant with their vision. It's much harder to ward all of the possible flanking opportunities when you're this far extended down mid lane versus just having the pit and teleport locations warded around you. And that's the thing about OMG. They have a great team fight as long as they're prepared for it. Again, they have the gangplank. He needs to make sure that his barrels are out and ready, because if there's ever a scenario where they get caught off the surprise, where RNG do get the jump on them, they're pretty much donezo.
An Icon is what? Like, we've seen the damage that he can do against any squishy on the side of RNG, so it's not all doom and gloom for the OMG lineup.
This guy's nuts.
This is some solid stake mission around the side.
See,
hasn't
mate.
Been alerted just yet. Kick him against the wall, finish him off. And Icon, he'll jump away very quickly. Bebe, he's onto the back line, but he's completely by himself, separated from the pack, and he just launched himself into the enemy team. Dwayne's gonna do the same thing, gonna pay the price. So these junglers are nuts.
What an absolute legend. Like, that's crazy. He's like, my team, we at least got one Baron buff. It's only on the DP. Finds the flank, kills Xiao Hu before he's able to use the Hourglass, and allows him to break mid and possibly take down Nautilus. Raid boss.
Oh, he's got the Guardian Angel, so there's a phase two to that fight. And OMG didn't even finish off the first one. Allow him to reset, go back to full HP.
I love Shui Shui.
So player.
The thing is Shui Shui came into the LPL. He does have a sub jungler on this roster with World 6. Very hit and miss. Now, he's known as a big Lee Sin player. You can obviously see why his mechanics are definitely on point. Decision making, not quite so much. But I love the OMG mentality of that they're always going to run for it, that they're never going to back up. It's kind of like, take the gamble, try the crazy play, and eventually you'll do crazy plays so often and so many times that they're no longer crazy. They're just the standard. And that's kind of like their motto.
I have a lot of respect for Lee Sin, whose both mind and body is telling him yes in pretty much every situation, which is what he's been doing. 4, 6, and 7, so his kill participation is through the roof. He's only missed out on one kill.
But the fact that he wasn't punished for that at all, like, how risky of a play. It's not like he ran in there with his sweeper. He just ran to the enemy jungle, like, completely confident that he's not going to walk over any vision and that Cinder's not going to know he's there and just turn and delete him.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it was absolutely a YOLO play, but it worked. So, I mean, you can't fault him for it.
It worked against RNG, and they're not looking too hot, although we'll see if they can clean it up and perhaps close out the series. They've lost their gold lead now, but they still have so many tools and so much power on this composition.
I actually really like that point you bring up, because we're looking at these two teams, and I'm not going to get a chance to talk because they just want to fight. Here comes the arrow, does not land onto 5. He's immune to arrows in this game.
Just in between the wickets.
Just in between. But going back to that point, it's like these two teams are looking towards the bottom side of the table. You know, you look at OMG and a lot of analysts talking to you guys, like, honestly, a team who are looking at last place in that group. RNG did not show up. Are they looking to rebuild? What can they do? But they, you know, of course, dropped their game earlier against IMA. So what can they do now? Are they also looking towards the bottom of the table? And those are all questions you have to ask. So coming out of this series, I feel like some of those questions will be illuminated. What's for certain is we're going to have a fight over Boova for some reason.
They lost it. Treyjoy actually managed to steal it away using his smite.
Got him.
Got him, coach. But in terms of RNG, I mean, this game at least, they've had the right idea. Unfortunately for Uzi, Letmi's been the primary benefactor of a lot of these right ideas, and some of the right ideas they've missed out because of execution. You know, the arrow's missing, or the teleport's coming in just slightly too late. Xiaohu, though, has certainly stepped up this game. I'm not seeing as many errors as we saw previously, and that's always nice to see. Of course, this could just be a symptom of the fact that he's on a champion like Syndra.
True, true. And
but OMG's problem has always just been that they're unfortunately in a region that's stacked with superstar talent. And they have good members. I mean, you can see Xuezhe how he might be impressive. And given time, given experience, given proper leadership, that he could become a standout Chinese jungler. Same thing with Icon. But it's just this issue that they don't necessarily have that built into their current roster. I mean, if SMLZ is your most veteran player on the roster, it kind of speaks volumes to it. So it's just about time with them.
For sure.
Xiong.
Trying to, like,
the role swap god himself from mid to support to top.
But I mean, trying to play catch up, as you know, against, like, teams, even like RNG, you know, who are significantly more longer standing in terms of just some of the players. It's hard to get to that point. But if they can play catch up and they can do it quickly, then, you know, there's no reason why they couldn't progress higher than bottom of the table.
I mean, what a contemporary timeline we're in where Royal never gives up, formerly known as Star and Royal Club, and OMG, even, you know, the Dark Forces never give up, that we're kind of predicting them now on bottom of the table. These two organizations were pillars of the LPL. OMG, I
sure.
mean, they were the Edward Gaming before EEG even existed. They stayed true to their old child. Oh no, five.
He's gonna live.
Baby.
Machi survived, or surprised Five has died as much as he had. It feels like he's escaped from so many situations he should have died in.
If MLXG was that Vi, Five would not be alive right now. Vi might not also be alive, but
I mean, baby's learning, right? Like, he's dived the back line probably two or three times where he just dived in and instantly died. I like the interactions between Vi and Caitlyn. That was in Chinese, so I don't know what they said, but it was cool regardless.
Nice try, Cupcake.
Probably the one.
That's
yeah.
the best I got.
Close enough. Ming, okay, they were giving that one a shot, but we'll get back over the wall. Just seeing if they can get that cheeky Baron out of vision.
Nice heads-up play from RNG. At this point, they need to get control over their lanes. I feel like we've constantly been seeing RNG with their lanes pushing into them before they really want to approach this pit. You can actually see that Letmi's finally pulling off the bottom side after he started to build up a slow push there. And I feel like we've seen this play a couple of times.
Out of vision though. Doesn't work once and try up. Uzi, he's got him. He's got their number. But that's okay, we'll back away. It was down to around half health and I was like, maybe OMG will try and commit to it. Nope. I'm going to do that one this time around.
But now we should be trading priority over the Baron. It should now fall back into RNG because they've got their waves under control. Again, that slow push from Letmi in about 30 seconds is really going to be a problem that OMG will have to address on the bottom side of the map. So RNG, all eyes are on you. You now have control over the map. You can move into the Baron pit. How are you going to set up the objective, especially with Elder Drake also live?
It would be a big tell for them as a team. Because even on like an individual basis, we're looking at them and saying, eh, not the star players compared to some other teams, so can they make it up in macro?
And
right now they're being shoved in.
Yeah, and they don't even want to try to play around with the vision game. They just want to help build. I was like, that seems a little bit risky. I can't believe they're actually just going to try to walk it in for that inhib. They smartly change their minds.
Yeah, go back.
So much of their composition is really empowered by Fog of War and actually playing the vision game correctly because they have such great pick potential like the Asher or like the Syndra Burst. I like this call a lot more.
Got a lot of health though. And OMG are here to contest. He'll have to walk through some bottlenecks, which is less than optimal. GP could put a spanner in the works.
Okay. I liked the idea of walking towards the Elder Drake. I didn't like the
idea of starting it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why don't you just stand behind a corner? Big issue is that they don't have any more of the control wards left. But look, they placed two. What? RNG, please!
That's hilarious. Well, they're going to walk into the mid lane now, and they know that they'll have to contest around the Baron area. And now OMG is going to start off the Baron. I just don't even know anymore.
Here's the Hawkshot, though.
Found him.
Okay.
All right. Back away.
Let's
teams need to stop starting objectives.
Let's make a gentleman's agreement. Everyone back. Pick up your control wards, or we're just going to go in. Changed his mind.
And I was going out. Didn't hit anything, so he's fine.
Meanwhile, Xiang, the bottom side of the map.
How's it going?
Deal with me.
I'm a GP. This is what I do.
Are they going to let it go?
And now RNG are going to go onto the Baron. There's a TP available for Xiang. At some point, I have to feel he'll be ulting to do something. Oh, there it is. Death's Daughter coming down.
Zui's
he's going to be looking for the steal, but it's secured by Bei Bei. And Zui is in way too deep. He'll be going down, but take a look at Xiang and what he's doing. He's like just taking the inhibitor.
They need to stall their backs. He can continue to go. Ooh, he's got a
freeway
behind
him. Oh, Icon walked into the face of death and did not come out swinging. But still, pretty good.
But in the end, RNG are going to lose so much pressure and power from their Baron because they're going to have to use it to deal with the super creep wave crashing into the bottom side of their map. Now, it was a huge error from Icon. Again, you can see the hero play that he's trying to make. If I stall their backs out long enough, we can maybe take a Nexus Tower. Yeah, right into a brick wall.
Not so great. Elder Dragon still on the board as a neutral objective. Both teams will want to try and stop this one, but with Caitlyn in the top lane, with that massive minion wave, it pretty much conceded to RNG. So that's a thing. So that will help them out.
You know, this is actually big because this means that now that they can have the confidence to walk whatever objective down that they want. If they choose to kind of play it really clinical, really safe, taking that last outer on the bottom, or, you know, we already saw that they were thinking about that mid inhibitor, and that's also an option for them.
And even for Letmi, you know, like he sits in the side lane, it's just like, ah, split foot Nautilus. But now he's going to burn through those waves so quickly with the true damage that it's actually not too bad anymore. And the rest of the team can just join him, so that also works, pushing in this wave. So after all of that, even though the inhib went down, walk to the bottom lane, push it out. With these two massive buffs on the side of RNG, they can start taking down objectives. Middle inhibitor may be something for them to look at while they still have this Elder Dragon. Not going to be on them for too much longer.
Yeah, it's still very scary to consider diving a Nexus turret with the likes of the Caitlyn trap set up, the Zyra ult up, as well as kind of the immediate burst damage that Icon just kind of can flash onto your back line with what he's doing with Ahri. So I like the calmer, cleaner play of saying, let's go mid, let's try to walk down that inhibitor without the tower, instead of just using the power of a dive comp like Vi, like Nautilus. Although, here
it's
we go.
It's time for some hype. Zuraze coming in. Uzi knocked over the wall. He'll instantly flash out. No one can get to him right now, but he can't hit anyone either. And that will mean the death of Bei Bei. He's going to go in. He's always going to go in. Oh, keeps his Guardian Angel. Double Zhonya's Hourglass. What does it mean? It means that both of them are dead. And Letmi moving on to Xiang. He goes down into his own Guardian Angel. Do they have the damage to finish him? Minx there, along with Uzi. Not going to leave him up to dry. That's his first step of the game. Don't worry, his KDA is intact.
And that was with the Elder Drake, though. So, again, that's another huge failure from RNG in setting up their vision. The fact that they didn't spot out the Lee Sin, and you know that that's going to be the standard play. Like, OMG, they have no flanking plays except for that Lee Sin insect kick. Zhui Zhui has the mechanics, he makes the play pay off, but frankly, that's RNG's failure just kind of handing the game back to OMG. Just ward your flanks.
Are we playing League of Legends or Ping Pong? I actually can't tell. Because this game has just gone back and forth so many times. Zhui Zhui is looking for another play. I'm sure he can make it. He's still got the Guardian Angel as well. That didn't even go down.
He is dragging OMG across this finish line.
He takes the shot. A lot of damage from five plants. I mean, he's got the two items as well, so that'll be opening up the mid and hip.
I feel like neither team actually wants Baron at this point, because anytime they get Baron, they actually lose ground.
That's the mark
base.
Of death, yeah. Actually, not a great objective to pick up. It's going to be at least 3 minutes until the next one, though. And Elder Dragon as well. So there's no big objectives for the teams to fight here, so we may just hit a bit of a quiet period just for a second. before those objectives come back up.
As bloodthirsty and as big of a fan as I am of the LPL, you know all about those 5v5s. Again, my biggest gripe right now is with the lack of control wards and how they're setting up these objectives. And that's really what's been the ping pong back and forth of these throws. As you can clearly see that in the gold.
You can see each serve, actually, as the peaks and troughs are in that graph. That's actually fantastic. On point graph. And this is actually a game that's gone quite a long time. I didn't realize it was 45 minutes into the game.
We're going to come down to a 50-50 single team fight.
Yeah. This has been quite a long one. We saw like long games, of course, in the second series of today. There was like very long games that felt long because there was not a lot of fighting, and when they did, it was in short bursts. But this has just been both teams scrapping for the most part. Okay, there's been a couple lulls in the last maybe 10 minutes. But it will start heating up again as these big objectives like Baron, like Elder Dragon, start spawning again. And it's just down to the team looking to secure that vision before those objectives spawn.
And we really need to point out the trinket differences between the teams as we start getting into like these really late games where their item slots are choked up, where you're only able to really hold three control wards on the support position, because Xiaohu's actually still sitting with his yellow trinket as well as Letmi. So they don't have the two blue trinkets. So if RNG actually ever lose priority and positioning over that Baron pit, it's super dangerous because they don't have the blue trinket to allow them to check safely, because there's still a ton of pick potential available in Icon. So they have to be so diligent with their wave control to make sure that they never get forced out of the Baron pit area by dealing with mid or dealing with bottom wave.
And to that point, the CZ Rot portal has been picked up. Beipei launching himself once again, this time into the front lines. Xiang is going to go down into his Guardian Angel. Dwayne maybe underneath the same fate. And he will be actually just jumping in there. Yeah, Uzi, he'll have to back away. And a lot of the damage that he was about to deal is completely down the toilet. Dwayne taken out there by Xiaohu. Ace in the horrible, not blocked up by Letmi. Looked like his model was maybe in front. But still, that was a one for one. Jungler's exchanged.
Did Ming hit the blast cone and force Ashe into the fight?
I think so. Yeah, that's a support he's going to get fired after this game. Xiang, onto this in here. See you later. Take that down. Uzi must be tilted off the face of the planet right now.
Look at RNG's comms. Look at Letmi's face right now. Like, Xiang, he looks focused. He looks calm and collected. Letmi actually just kind of looks displeased.
Yeah.
7-1 and 6. That's a ridiculous scoreline.
Displeased is a great word to describe Letmi's face right now. Beibei, how's he looking? He's communicating. That's good. I want to see Uzi's face. I want to see an Uzi play cam. Can we get that one?
I mean, there's that very famous sequence of Uzi, you know, in tears in between his games and having the coach and the counselor come out and try to console him in between games. It's no secret that Uzi has a bit of a temperamental streak. Kind of did grow out of that, but a lot of pressure. That's the big thing about competing in the LPL is you're competing in front of one of the largest League of Legends audiences in the world, and so when you face that lashback, it's very loud.
Exactly. When you're an emotional player already, you can have those really high highs, but also those really low lows. Uzi, I think, nailed by that Death's Daughter. He's down to 60%. Does have the Honey Fruit there. And we'll go back to full health.
The nice thing, though, is RNG just have to be patient here because they have both the top and the bottom wave about to force OMG to reposition. So take your time with this Baron. Don't force a 50-50.
Okay. Seems to be pretty much what RNG is doing right now. Not taking too much damage.
But what OMG are waiting for is the super creep wave in the mid lane. So while RNG have control of their side lanes, OMG are just buying time for the super creeps. Okay. Yep. She's taking care of one priority.
It's gone up. Okay, what does this mean for the Baron? It's down to a third.
Oh no.
It could come down to it. Again, five untouchable with those arrows. Tewa's landing. He comes in. He gets the steal. Dwayne may have just saved this one coming in from the OMG. Baby on the front lines instantly decimated. Jiang, triple knockup coming in from Letmi. He just sealed the fate of his entire team. Five, an Icon trying to run away from this fray, but what can they do? That was disastrous for OMG.
But OMG, or excuse me, RNG can't really capitalize on it because they need to return to their base unless they go all in or nothing and just try to run it down mid lane. Nope, they're taking the smarter call, they're gonna reset their backs, and they have to take care of their Nexus tower. So even though RNG win the teamfight, it doesn't mean anything. It's still disaster.
Letmi playing tower defense right now in the base, and that was so scrappy. But Zreje picking up that Baron there, so honestly, fantastic steal. It just came down to a smiting mechanics.
That is, I will never use the word fantastic there. I know.
I mean, he got the Baron.
But the fact that the teams are putting themselves in positions where they're taking the 50-50.
Let's see it again. Let's see if it actually was fantastic. I actually don't know what happened there. That was too fast.
Yeah, I mean, he finds the Q, he's got the execute, comes in and makes a steal. It's a pretty stable play on the Lee Sin. It's why it's always scary when you take the 50-50 Baron Smite like that. And then, unfortunately, this is the big thing, is that the Super Creep Wave is on the Nexus Towers, and OMG know that at that point, we have the Baron, we actually just need to disengage. There's no reason to take the fight, and unfortunately, RNG used all their cooldowns, were unable to chase and punish.
Look at Xiao, who's damaged in that last team fight as well. A lot of that was actually from the final play where Xiang was like, let me just deliver this Nautilus Ultimate into three players. And it was just like, okay, let me follow up on that one. That was pretty much where most of that 5,000 damage came from. Well, we are 50 minutes in, Frosk. And like you were saying earlier, probably going to come down to one of those big team fights which will decide the entire game, especially with all of these open inhibs. So one big team fight from here, we'll decide it.
There's kind of the difference about how the teams will be approaching trying to end the game, though, depending on when they have power. So it's this idea that when RNG, when they have the Baron, when they feel that they're in power, they're all grouped up together and they're just running down as, you know, the flying V, like the Mighty Ducks. Whereas OMG, you know, it's much more kind of guerrilla warfare. You've got Shui Shui, he's looking for that flank. He's trying to slip in underneath your vision line. They've make sure that Xiang is always across map for them, or they're playing and setting up around his barrels, and they're trying to splinter different lanes and pull OMG apart. So this is where, even though, excuse me, RNG apart, where even though OMG are technically in the tempo in the driver's seat, they're still very respectful of RNG, because that 5v5 comp, when everyone's together, is still utterly terrifying.
Sure. One Nexus turret remaining. RNG absolutely on the back foot. JJ, a pick here. Could be really good. Arrow, CC chain. He's still got the Guardian Angel. He'll jump in as far as he can. Maybe see if the rest of the team can follow up. But with the bullet time on top of him, he's just going to simply fall over. Bebe was there to secure his fate. With almost a 77-second death timer, RNG buy a lot of time for themselves. And with the spawn of Elder Dragon.
Xiaohu is, however, in the base right now, resetting his health bar, so they don't have their Cinder to immediately walk up to the pit, which is what is delaying this. They should just walk towards it.
That would make sense, but they're running down mid right now. They really want the inhib. Who knows what RNG wants in reality. Big mini wave in both top and bot they will have to deal with. Yeah, it looks like they want the inhib more than anything, and maybe loop back for the Elder Dragon, but they are running out of time, and there's a big trap line.
Still 30 seconds, though. They get to play with the 4v5. Now they don't need to worry about the threat of Shui Shui, you know, appearing behind Uzi, flash kicking him into certain death.
It's one thing to look out for, but just inching around this trap line. Very difficult to deal with. Xiang getting caught out. There's the ultimate and the CC chain once again from RNG. They find one. They're looking for the second. Bebe still with his Guardian Angel. Will burn his flash to keep that one alive. Charging up the Vault Breaker. Does not have flash, remember. Harder for him to land onto the player that he wants. But with the mid lane breached, they will look for another one now. Let me charging into the front lines. Stopping that damage from Caitlyn. Dredge line doesn't quite connect. I feel like at this point, surely RNG will back away.
And finally, the pings go down for the Elder Drake. Now, Shui Shui is back alive, but Xiang is dead, so still a 4v5 disadvantage for IMA, but they, excuse me, for OMG, but they have the potential to look for a smite steal now. Which is why I like that RNG are actually trying to clear out the vision behind them and setting up for possibly a Fnatic Death Brush, but Icon's actually moved up underneath him. He could catch Uzi coming around this corner.
Big minion wave bot lane, someone's gonna have to deal with that. Icon.
Just shadowing
lying
underneath.
In wait, it can catch pretty much anyone.
It's fine, Let Me has teleport, so he's gonna clear the minion wave.
He's gonna be waiting for his chance. Bebe coming almost back up to full health as well. In pretty good shape. The standoff continues, but there's not long until Gangplank respawns, and he has TP, so I think that will be RNG backing away for now. Let Me continuing to farm 7-1-9. Like, pretty much immortal in this game.
I mean, we're sitting at 100k gold. Everyone's got 6 items. There's no longer any room for control wards. the big vision differences are still going to be the fact that OMG are playing on two blue trinkets versus two yellow trinkets on RNG.
At what point, when you're like, I don't know, 70 minutes into a game and you have Misfortune support, you say, you know what, I'm just going to store my items and go ADC.
He actually has a Rylai's as well.
Yeah.
So he's
a while.
Utility armor pen. As here's the Hail Mary. Is he going to find anyone? He's fast.
He's very fast. Oh, he's going to pause for a second. Finds the Q. Actually knocks him out of the way of the arrow, which lands onto 5 instead. But I think he hit the Banshees.
But they have the priority positioning coming up into the mid lane, so OMG, they have to go the long way around. They're getting zoned out by Bebe, or I guess corralled. And they're now across map from Elderdrake.
Wow, that was a really interesting sequence of events. It was like, there's nothing in the mid lane, but because they were drawn into mid lane, that being from OMG, his RNG can go straight for this Elder Dragon.
They're burning now, it very
OMG,
quickly.
Yeah, they're beelining over to them. There's a Gangplank ultimate, lots of damage onto some of the key members there. It's only down to half right now. Choice, can he come out with another miracle steal? Could secure this game one. Dropping low, down to 3,000.
Dre Dre
jumping in.
He's
can
in
you get
line.
This one? Once again with the second steal of the game. Dre Dre coming up big. Bebe getting caught out here. He'll drop down into the Guardian Angel. Dre Dre going in onto Uzi. Knocks him out of the fight, allowing Icon into the pit. He goes into the Zhonya's Hourglass. Xiaohu trying to stay alive while Letmi comes back up. But not going to happen. A 4-for-1. Favor of OMG, Uzi the only man left standing.
And surely with 70 to 60 second death timers left, OMG have enough space and enough time to walk this one down. We said, what is this team good at? They still have retained their 5v5 identity, and 56 minutes in this game, it came down to the 5v5, and they managed to outplay RNG.
Absolutely nuts. Uzi is going to put one last ditch effort and has to clear out the middle lane of
He's
minions.
Trying to catch the wave behind them so that the 66 damage reduction for the tower comes into play. But nice teleport from Xiong means that he'll simply slow them down but not stop the inevitable.
If only there was two towers, maybe he could have done something. But after 57 minutes, game one, just game one, goes over to OMG.
And you don't feel great after a game like that. We kind of talked about it a bit during the cast, but that was huge failures and oversights by both teams in terms of their vision control, especially in how you're playing such high burst assassin pick comps like that. Although Uzi looking pretty positive on your screen.
Yeah, for sure. And we're welcoming back Mr. Rusty. What are your thoughts on that game? It was definitely a long one.
Well,
you made it back just
in
time.
That was horrible. It was